Assalamualaikum and hello YouTube, my name is Nur Muhammad from Animosh and yes, I'm back with another strap review. Okay, so this time around, this is not a strap that was sent in to me by your favorite strap maker, but rather this is a purchase that I've bought using my own money from AliExpress. Okay, so recently I've seen a craze or an increase in trend of this French paratrooper straps. So namely the stand trend was started by this was it NMN strap or Erika original strap? I can't remember who started it first, but anyway, so these things has been going up popularity. But to get one, I would have to fork out about $55 for any of these if I want to buy the original. Okay, so typical to my style, I would like to test out if there's any other alternative so that when I use them and I think, okay, it's worth to buy the real thing. So I searched through, eBay and AliExpress and all that stuff and found these straps. Okay, so of course, if you want to compare it to $55, of course it's going to be different, but I'm trying it out just for this, just for curiosity, and if I do like the actual strap that it might come if I bought the original thing, right? So this is an alternative. So I'm not gonna say to you guys right now that, okay, go ahead and buy this cheap one and don't get the Erika originals, whatever. But this is one way for you to try it out first before you fork out your $55 for the real thing. Okay, so before that, we should do a quick swatch check today. I am still wearing my Punis Batman GMT, another homage watch to the Rolex Batman GMT. And yes, it is on this cheaper Sinatra strap, another Marine National style strap, but this time around it is in blue and also in white. Okay, so I've done the review for this particular watch, but I haven't done a review for this particular strap, so go ahead and check out my video archives if you want to see or hear what I have to say about this watch. Okay, so let's get back to the strap. So I've ordered this through a seller in AliExpress. I will give you a link down below. Okay, on his listing or her listing on this website on AliExpress, they mentioned that these straps come in three different sizes, which is 20mm, 21mm, and also 22mm. But in reality, well technically I've ordered these two first, so I've ordered it in 20mm because as you guys know, the Seiko Monster has a 20mm lug and also the Caddison has a 20mm lug. So I went out and ordered it, both of these, and when it came to me, it's actually not 20mm. So you can see here there is a bit of protrusion here, right? So you can see that it's not really fitting to the lugs of this Seiko Monster, right? So there's a bit of extra material here. So after that, I've opened dispute to the seller, and the seller agreed to give me a refund. And after that, I just want to say, yeah, well, let's try again and go ahead and order the 22mm strap. And it came, because I wanted to use it on my Aubrey Morgan Perata. Of course, the strap came, but again, when I put it on this Aubrey Morgan Perata, so you can see there is a, come on, camera focus, you can see that there is a gap here, right? So, but the buckle is actually a wee bit bigger, so rare, like that. Okay, so this is the difference between 20mm and 22mm, just the buckle. But the straps, I've took out my caliper and it is actually 21mm. So guys, don't bother specking out 20, 21, or 22mm, because it is going to come in 21mm. So I'm not really sure whether there is only that particular seller has this type of problem, but yeah, maybe you should expect that. Okay, so that's it about what I don't like about the seller or the product itself. But as itself, the product is really, really nice. Okay, so I've wondered why the heck that why the heck didn't I search or didn't I bought these straps quite much more earlier, because it is really comfortable. Okay, so of course when you see the material, it is that stretchy material that you would find on your bags or whatever. So I'm not really sure, I haven't handled the original MN strap or the Erika's original strap. Maybe they have a much more premium feeling considering their $55 price, but for something that is, I paid how much, I think I paid about 13 or 14 bucks for each of these. So for that price, this is really nice. You can see that, wow, I could stretch it like that. So it came in, you can order it in, I think it came with a brush and PVD black and also a rose gold. If you guys follow my channel long enough, you would know that I only prefer brush buckle for my hardware. So we have this unsigned buckle here, and we have this adjusting loop here, and of course this is where you fix the buckle like so. Okay, so this is how you fix it. Okay, so how do you want to fit it to the watch itself? So let's see how I put it on my watch. So let's start with the with this one. Okay, so what you want to do is you're gonna need to put the strap first, then you put the spring bar on top of it. So you can see like so. So you can't really do as you normally do with your narrow strap. So once you've got those spring bars in, make sure that it is tight by pulling this one and also this side, and you are good to go. Okay. So some people wear it. You know what? I'll just put it on so that you can understand how you want to wear this one. Right. So. Okay, let's take this one off. Okay, so I'm gonna put this one in. So you're gonna, because of this one single piece, it is not thick, it doesn't make your watch feel thick on the wrist. And when you put it like so, just have to take this one in and oops, put it on this particular. It's very difficult, not very difficult, but you kind of get used to it. Okay, so I wear it like so. Okay, so this side of the key, what do you call this, keeper, is on my inner wrist. Okay, in what do you call inner wrist, this side of my wrist, and this side is on what do you call on this on here. So nothing is under my wrist. So why I do that, because when if let's say I'm using a computer, so there's nothing on my wrist, so I feel comfortable. And when I stretch or flex my wrist, there's nothing that will touch at the underside of my wrist. Okay, so some people I saw use it like here. So maybe demonstrate using this one. So some people use it like that, so it's near to this side. So what happened is when you do that, it will, let me show you guys what I mean by this. Oops. Okay, so let's see if I can do this for you guys on camera. And you can see that this particular buckle is on my, it's under my wrist. So that's not good. For me, it's kind of, you know what, it's kind of annoying, because there's something, there's a metal down here, so you can feel it, and it can maybe sometimes hurts your under wrist. So that is why I prefer to use it like so. So by doing this, I have much more flexibility, and I can achieve this clean look to the strap itself. Okay, so this is how I use my this, what do you call this, imitation, or you want to call it fake or whatever. So this is how I use these straps. So I think all in all, it's as a conclusion, this is a really nice alternative if you don't want to fork out that $55 for an MN strap or the Erika's original. But if you do, you know what, just give it a try, and if you like this style of strap, maybe you could, you know, you could justify buying that original, you know, Erika's original strap. You know what, I don't really support fake products, but I believe I treat this as a, how to say, competitor, so that maybe in the future, Erika's original or MNN Stripe would, reduce their price so that it is they are much, much more affordable for us watch lovers in the world. Okay, so what do you think about these stripes, guys? So not bad as a conclusion. As a conclusion, it's not bad, that bad. So currently they have this green and red, and they have this green and yellow, and of course this black and white. I believe they will also come out. They have also another colors which is not really that interesting to me, but yeah, a nice alternative nonetheless. Okay, so what do you guys think? So if you guys like this video, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you guys want to see more future content such as this, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, and also click the notification bell button below so that you won't miss any of my future videos. So until next time, I'll see you soon. Bye bye.